Hi everyone, welcome to my channel Suchi Stream, Improve Your Life Using Technology. 6 months back, I have created a video on dishwasher and I am very much thankful to all of you for appreciating it. It has crossed 1 lakh plus views with your support. And on this milestone, I am planning a giveaway contest in this month. So please watch my complete video for the contest quiz. And also don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so far. Now talking about the topic of today's video, I have received a number of constructive comments in my previous video to explain few things in detail. For example, how effectively dishwasher cleans dishes, how effectively does dishwasher cleans hard stains, can dishwasher clean Indian utensils properly, if utensils comes out completely dry, does it clean aluminium cooker, does it take too much of time, can big cooker like 4 liter cooker can fit into the dishwasher. So I promise my viewers to make one more detailed demo video. I'll also share my experience and learning after 9 months of usage of dishwasher. Before loading my dishes in the dishwasher, let me show you my used utensils for today. Here is the sink. You can see the different types of dishes here. Now let's first start with my cooker. This is 3.5 liter steel cooker. So you can see the food stain here. So you can see the inside condition of the cooker. The back side of the steel cooker. So you can see the burnt mark here. This won't go, but then little bit it will get cleaned. This is the lid of the cooker. So you can see the stains are here. This is the hard stain accumulated here, and you can see the inside condition of the lid. So you can see the small particles of food here and there. So this is my steel tea saucepan. You can notice the tea burn mark here, and there is also tea left over here. This I'll throw it off and then I'll put in the dishwasher. Based on my learning, I'll recommend to scrub the hard stain a bit before putting in dishwasher. However, for demo purpose, I'll scrub only small area of the saucepan and leave the hard stain on remaining area so that you can see the effectiveness of cleaning by the dishwasher. So I have thrown the tea particles. So you can see the condition of my saucepan now. The stains are visible clearly. So now after seeing the bottom of the saucepan, you can see this is the copper layer which got discolored after using for 9 months on daily basis. You can see, and this is the reason why copper and aluminium vessels are not recommended to clean in the dishwasher. But let's not worry about outside layer of the copper. So now I'm going to scrub the half part of the saucepan so that you can see the difference how it gets cleaned if you have scrubbed the hard stain before putting in the dishwasher and if you have not. So this is the area, this side area, I'll scrub it. So this way you have to just scrub a little and then you can put in the dishwasher. So now you can see this area, I have scrubbed it nicely, and this is the area where it is, there is the hard stain, hard dried stain. So let's see how dishwasher is going to clean it. You can see the milk stain here outside the saucepan, and I am not going to scrub this, but let's see how my dishwasher is going to clean it. This is my 3.5 liter aluminium cooker. I don't use aluminium cooker on daily basis, but I am cleaning it today for demo purpose. Earlier I cleaned it on regular basis in dishwasher for a couple of months, and you can see it has discolored after frequent cleaning in dishwasher. So it's recommended not to use aluminium vessels in the dishwasher. So you can see the stains here. There is the hard stain this side. So this is the hard stain on the back side of the cooker. So you can see the dried mark on top of the lid. And this is the inside view of the lid. So this is my 3.2 liter steel kadhai. You can see the mark here, food stain mark. So all over the kadhai. The back side of my steel kadhai, you can see the burnt mark. So here I am scrubbing in the back side of the kadhai. so that this hard stain should go, although it will not go completely. So this is my steel tray for dough making. I have used it for kneading the dough. You can see the dough mark. So these are my ceramic cups and plate. You can see it has been used for tea, so you can see the tea marks, and then for milk along with few particles of cornflakes and muesli. You can see here again the tea marks, and this is for the snacks. I have used it. So this is the steel plate, which there are 3-4 steel plates and few bowls, steel bowls and the plastic bowls. You can see it was all left over in the sink. Now this all I am going to put in the dishwasher. So this is dishwasher friendly plastic. So this is glass, this also I am going to put in the dishwasher. So you can see it's dirty, it's not looking that transparent as it should look. So this is another steel utensil. This I have used for making oats, but then it got burnt little bit in the bottom, you can see. So I'll remove this leftover oats part and then I'll scrub it little bit and then I'll put in the dishwasher. This is the back side. So this is a spatula, a kanchul. So you can see it's dirty. So this is wooden waterproof spatula. So this is the tea strainer. So this is another steel utensil. So you can see there are other few plates and spoons and small bowls, other utensils which we use on daily basis. Dishwasher. So I'm going to load the dishes here. Before loading, we have to make sure that we'll see if any extra food particles are left over here in the filter side. So you can see, due to my previous wash, so here is the fan from where water will come out, and this is the reason we have to put the utensils upside down, because water comes from down. Now I am going to load my dishwasher with the dishes, and here I am starting the timer, and we'll see how much time it takes to load the dishes in the dishwasher. So it took 3 minutes and 45 seconds to load the dishes in the dishwasher. I've kept the lid of the cooker like this so that both the sides get cleaned properly. So now my both the rack of dishwasher is full. So before starting the dishwasher, I'll check the fan if it is free. So this way you can check. So if it gets touched with any of the vessels, like spoon, usually it gets touched and then it makes a sound, but here you can see it's free. And then I'll check the fan, down fan. So here this is also free. So now my dishwasher is ready to run. Here I am going to put 5-in-1 tablet. Now I'll switch on the dishwasher from here. This is a switch on and off button, and I have selected intensive kadhai mode, which takes 1 hour and 35 minutes. You can see here, and I'll just start the dishwasher. So you can see the indication of refill salt and refill rinse it. Since I'm using 5-in-1 tablet, so it's not required. My viewer has asked about the sound, so you can hear the sound. It's very silent. So dishwasher has completed its cleaning. Now let's open it. So yesterday night I had put all the utensils in the dishwasher, and today morning, this is the next day, in the morning I'm opening it. So usually I do like this. So you can see there is no water droplets. It's all the utensils are completely dry. Now I'll show you the cleaning results of each utensils one by one. The kadhai first. So you can see it's almost clean. So you can see the back side of the kadhai as well. Let's see how cooker has been cleaned. So you can see this is cooker. It has been cleaned. So this burn mark will go if we will scrub it before putting in the dishwasher. Since water jets comes from down of the dishwasher, that's why the inside part of the utensils gets cleaned properly. But the outside of the dish utensils, like this back side, it gets less water pressure, and that. Now let's see the aluminium cooker. So this is the lid. You can see it's clean. So if you remember, there was some hard stain over the lid, so it has gone and it's cleaned. Now we'll see the cooker. So you can see the inside part. There was, although this hard stain has not gone, but then if you remember, there were little vegetable stains, and that has gone. Now let's see the dough tray. So you can see the hard stain has gone. It has been cleaned very nicely. So now let's see the plates. So this is the steel plate. You can see it has been so nicely cleaned. Now we'll see the ceramic plates. It is also very nicely clean. Now let's see the utensils from the upper rack. So first I'll show you the cooker lid. So you can see how much it has been cleaned. Almost it has cleaned from inside, except the small marks. You can see the small mark. And we'll see the back side. So yeah, so the upper side of the lid usually doesn't get cleaned properly. So this hard stain should have been scrubbed before putting in the dishwasher. Since I haven't scrubbed it to show you, it has still been there. So let's see this utensil. If you remember, there was a burnt mark here. I had made a oat here in this. So it has gone and it has nicely cleaned. Now let's see the tea saucepan. So I had showed you the condition before. Let's see. Yeah. So if you remember, I had scrubbed half part of this saucepan. So you can see this part was scrubbed before putting in the dishwasher. So it has been cleaned, but then this part was not scrubbed. You can see the tea stain is still there. So it's always recommended to scrub the hard stain before putting in the dishwasher. And now we'll see the back side. So you see, this is the copper part and it has been discolored after 9 months of usage in the dishwasher. Let's see other utensils. So this has been cleaned nicely. There was no hard stain. Now let's see the mugs. So if you remember, there was tea stain and milk stain and few particles of cornflakes. I'll put it here. So it has completely gone. So there's no mark of tea or milk. So now let's see the tea strainer. It has been cleaned, but since I kept it like this, there are few tea particles which is left here. If I would have kept it like this, it would have cleaned nicely. So make sure to keep it like this. Let's see the spatula. So you can see it's clean, but this is the old burnt mark. So this is another wooden spatula, you can see. Now let's see, this is the steel spatula, you can see. It has been cleaned nicely. So this is dishwasher friendly plastic. You can see the condition. See the glass? If you could remember, it was not that transparent. Now it has been nicely clean and transparent and it's sparkling. So now let's see the spoon. It's so nicely cleaned. All the spoons has been nicely cleaned. And now we'll see the glass. Steel glass, it has been cleaned nicely. The bowls all have been cleaned so well. So now my verdict on cleaning effectiveness. Most of the utensils got cleaned very well. However, cooker lids, outer area, tea saucepans burnt mark didn't go 100%. For better cleaning, I would recommend to scrub this before loading into dishwasher. The utensils are fully dried and there is no droplet, as you have already seen. After cleaning, I use my dishwasher as a storage cupboard as well. So you should put only compatible utensils in the dishwasher. Since in my 9 months of usage, I have spoiled 2-3 utensils because they were not compatible. Please check my other video on compatible and non-compatible utensils. Hope it clarified your doubts regarding dishwasher. If you have any further doubt, feel free to comment. Talking about giveaway contest, till next 1 month, that is 12th July 2021, I'll ask a giveaway quiz in all my upcoming videos. You just have to answer in the comment box below. After 1 month, I'll do a lucky draw to announce the winner. And lucky draw winner will get a truly wireless Bluetooth earpod. So please subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon to get notifications regarding all my upcoming videos. So today's quiz question is, which washing mode did I select while starting a dishwasher? Please answer in the comment box below. And also like and share the video with your friends and family to improve their life. Thank you for watching. Stay tuned with Suchi's stream.